SpaceX is a leader in aerospace innovation. The company is working to develop a fully reusable launch system, capable of returning astronauts to the moon and enabling humans to colonize Mars. SpaceX also envisions a future where Starship can be an alternative for point-to-point travel on Earth. The launch system consists of Starship and the Super Heavy rocket, that will lift off from Starbase, Stage 0, which is the launch mount and all the ground support equipment. Including the 400-foot-tall orbital launch tower, that will have mechanical arms, to stack the spacecraft atop the booster and catch the vehicles as it returns from space. SpaceX has not released an official render depicting how the booster will be caught yet. An incredible render by Eric on Twitter shows how SpaceX plans to catch Starship and the Super Heavy rocket with Mechazilla. SpaceX founder Elon Musk said that the render animation is pretty close to how the vehicles will be caught. Booster and arms will move faster. QD quick disconnect, arm will steady booster for ship mate, Musk wrote in response to the video render. Starship will be caught by Mechazilla too. As with booster, no landing legs. Those are only needed for Moon and Mars until there is local infrastructure, he added. Catching the 230-foot-tall booster will enable fast reusability. Starship booster, largest flying object ever designed, will be caught out of sky by launch tower. Big step forward, as reflight can be done in under an hour, Musk said earlier this year. Ideal scenario, in my opinion, is catching Starship in horizontal glide, with no landing burn, although that is quite a challenge for the tower. Next best is catching with tower, with emergency pad landing mode on skirt, no legs, he added. Just one skyscraper catching another, Musk joked. The Super Heavy booster will be caught with load points just below the grid fins, and shock absorption is built into tower arms. Since tower is ground side, it can use a lot more mass to arrest booster downward momentum, he described in April. While true, catching Super Heavy by its grid fins would likely demand that control surfaces, and the structures they attach to be substantially overbuilt. Especially if Musk means that, the crane arm mechanism would be able to catch anywhere along the deployed fins 7 meters, 23 feet length. Even more importantly, it seems extraordinarily unlikely that such a complex and unproven recovery method could be made to work reliably on the first one or several tries, implying that early boosters will still need some kind of rudimentary landing legs. In other words, much like direct-to-launch mount landings, mid-air crane catch recovery is probably not a feature expected to debut on Super Heavy. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk says that Starship's Super Heavy boosters could forego landings entirely, relying instead on a wild crane-based solution to recover the world's largest rocket stage. The Super Heavy booster tasked with carrying a 1,400-ton Starship around 25% of the way to orbit will be the largest rocket stage ever built, and by a large margin. Prior to today, December 30th, SpaceX's plan was to more or less recover Super Heavy boosters, in a similar fashion to Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, landing them either far downrange on an ocean-based platform, or returning to touchdown as close as possible to the launch pad. Ever since the first iteration of SpaceX's Mars rocket was publicly revealed in 2016. SpaceX and CEO Elon Musk have also maintained a consistent desire to land Super Heavy boosters directly on top of the launch mount after a great deal of refinement. Launch mount recovery would require unprecedented precision and accuracy, and add a new element of risk, or a need for extraordinarily sturdy pad hardware. However, the benefits would be equally significant, entirely eliminating the need for expensive recovery assets, time-consuming transport, and even the time it would take to crane Super Heavy boosters back onto the launch mount, from a pad-adjacent landing zone. Instead, Musk says that SpaceX might be able to quite literally catch Super Heavy in midair, grabbing the booster before it can touch the ground by somehow slotting an elaborate launch tower arm underneath its steel grid fins. Although such a solution sounds about as complex and risky as it gets, it would technically preclude the need for any and all booster recovery infrastructure, even including the legs Super Heavy would otherwise need. SpaceX is preparing to conduct its debut orbital test flight with a fully stacked Starship Super Heavy rocket this year. However, during the first flight attempt they do not plan to catch the booster with the launch tower arm. According to a filing with the Federal Communications Commission, the Starship orbital test flight will originate from Starbase, Texas. The booster stage will separate approximately 170 seconds into flight. The booster will then perform a partial return and land in the Gulf of Mexico approximately 20 miles from the shore. SpaceX told the FCC in the filing document, the orbital Starship will continue on flying between the Florida Straits. It will achieve orbit until performing a powered, targeted landing approximately 100 kilometers off the northwest coast of Hawaii, in a soft ocean landing. The company stacked the launch vehicle for the first during a fit test on August 6. It was unstacked to continue preparing the spacecraft ahead of its pre-flight test campaign. SpaceX successfully launched and landed the rocket. The Starship is currently humanity's best chance of reaching Mars, as there are no other private companies or space agencies with a made program to send humans further than the Moon. The company hopes to achieve crewed missions to Mars before the end of the decade, and it's also launching a satellite called Doge 1, which Elon Musk has called the first meme in space. The majority of SpaceX rockets have always landed back on Earth, with the aid of deployable legs around the rocket. But the company intends to get rid of the method to save weight, where future spacecrafts may not need landing legs at all, even with the Super Heavy. SpaceX intends to catch the rocket after it launches Starship into orbit, and there's no doubt that catching the rocket will allow for effective and quick reusability. Elon Musk mentioned that the Starship booster, the largest flying object ever designed, will be caught out of the sky by a launch tower. Big step forward, as reflight can be done in under an hour. He further went on to say that, ideal scenario in my opinion is catching Starship in horizontal glide, with no landing burn, although that is quite a challenge for the tower. Next best is catching with tower with emergency pad landing mode on skirt, no legs, for better understanding. It is simply put as one skyscraper catching another, but Musk mentioned that the vehicles will use legs to land on the Moon and on Mars. The very first Super Heavy boosters that will land successfully will therefore be carefully analyzed and studied before being allowed to launch again. In fact, the Super Heavy does not actually need to refly in less than an hour to have a huge impact on space travel. Any reusable rocket that can launch at maximum once in a month would definitely be a huge leap ahead of anything ever achieved, including the world record held for the most reused rocket by SpaceX's B1049 booster, or NASA's best record for putting the same shuttle into orbit in 55 days. If we could get a rocket that could launch every week, we'll begin to see a significant reduction in the cost of space transportation. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching, and goodbye.